Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.6.1 to the public. This is available to all iOS 13 supported devices, so if you have any version of iOS 13, you'll be able to install this version right now around the world. It comes out at the same time worldwide, and so if you're not seeing it, go to your settings, go to General, then Software Update, and you should see it and be able to install it. If you have automatic updates turned on, it won't show up, so you may need to turn that off. Now on my iPhone 11, it came in at 109.4 megabytes. Now it's going to vary, but it was as little as 80 megabytes or so on my iPhone 6S Plus. Now let's take a look at what's new, talk about the build number, and see how it performs. Now along with this update, Apple also released iPadOS 13.6.1, along with macOS Catalina 10.15.6 supplemental update, and at least at the time of this video, they have not released an update for the Apple Watch, so look for that. It may be released later tonight. It's hard to say. Now let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. The build number is 17G80, and this particular update addresses a few issues people were having, but the first thing it doesn't address is a modem update. So if you were having issues with connectivity, whether that be on this iPhone 11, the iPhone 6S Plus that I have here, an iPad, or an iPhone 11 Pro Max, or any of those, it doesn't seem to address it. I'm not seeing it on those devices. You may see it, but I'm not seeing it. Now, the first issue that they've actually fixed has to do with storage. So, for example, it addresses an issue where unneeded system data files might not be automatically deleted when available storage is low. So maybe you have a 64 gigabyte iPhone, it's close to being completely full, and you go to your storage, and a lot of it's taken up by other. Well, now it's going to delete all of that information correctly so that it can free up space so you can actually use it for apps and photos and different data that you have that matters to your device. So that's the first thing they've fixed. The second thing they've fixed actually has to do with those with OLED displays. And what's interesting is that they say that it fixes a thermal management issue that caused some displays to exhibit a green tint. So that green tint issue that some people were having for quite some time on their iPhone 11 Pro Max or 11 or all the way back to the iPhone 10, that green tint issue is now fixed. So when you turn off your phone, turn it back on, it should now work properly and no longer have that tint on the display, and it should be accurate like it always is with iPhone displays. So it should be nice and color accurate at this point. Now the final thing they've fixed has to do with exposure notifications. Previously, there was an error where it might be disabled for some users, and now they've made it so that it will work properly if you have an app that will use it. So if you go into your settings and then you scroll down to privacy, under privacy, go to health, and you'll see exposure logging. You can't turn this on unless you have an app that wants to use it. So your local authority may have that app. If it doesn't, this won't be available to you, but you'll see that it's under health now, and that's where you can access it to change whether you want it on or off. Even if you have an app installed that uses it, you still have to turn it on. So right now it's turned off by default, and that's something they've actually fixed. Now that's it for everything they've told us about as far as bug fixes. That doesn't mean they haven't fixed anything else or improved anything else, but that's what they wanted us to know about. And then also there's a link to security updates as well, but there's no public security updates that they've told us about. So hopefully there's some security updates in here. They linked to it, and I can link to it in the description so you can check that out as well, where they update it regularly. Now, other than that, battery on this particular update should be interesting because iOS 13.6, quite a few people more recently have told me that they've been having more and more issues with it. And that's kind of interesting because the follow-up I did with iOS 13.6, over 70% said battery was better than iOS 13.5.1 or newer. So basically, many people said it was great, and then more and more recently, I've been told that it's getting worse. So on this particular iPhone 11, it's not my main device normally, but you'll see my battery health is 100%, and people were saying where they would normally get 7 or 8 hours, maybe they'd get 5. But I've actually found that in my use and other people I know that use it, they've had no issues. So I think it really depends on the hardware you're using, but it shouldn't really be affected across all devices. Now, as far as performance over the couple of hours that I've been using it, or at least hour and a half, it seems like it's performing pretty well. You'll see things are loading nice and fast, and the device isn't hot, so it doesn't seem like it's actually doing a whole lot in the background. It was just a patch, and hopefully it fixed a few things so that performance is really good. I know quite a few people were having issues, so I don't think it will be anything major as far as a change from what you had, but hopefully it fixes those bugs you were having. Now, as far as performance on older devices, well, the iPhone 6S Plus I was playing around with a little bit too. So you can see this is the first time I opened music. So it's taking a little bit to load off of Wi-Fi, but it looks like scrolling is smooth. If we go into settings here, that's nice and smooth. And also if we scroll over, I opened Minecraft just to check frame rates like I normally do. So all of your games should still work on this, unlike iOS 14 beta 4. But you'll see as I move around here, I noticed some of the draw distance sort of drawing in the background took a while to fill in on this particular one as soon as I loaded it. But it looks like everything's okay as far as frame rates go. And I would expect performance to be the same or better, at least based on how it feels. But we'll take a look at benchmarks in a moment. Now, iPadOS gets the same updates, at least for storage anyway, but it didn't really get anything other than that. So as far as updates to the overall OS, there's nothing mentioned other than that storage issue. So since none of the iPads have OLED displays at this point, they're all LCDs, there shouldn't be the green tint. And then also they don't get notifications for exposure as well. So seems like it's working okay. Again, let's take a look at the performance based on benchmarks and see what that comes in at. So on the iPhone 11, I used Geekbench 5. There it is. And you can see I had 1,331 for single core, 3,179 for multi-core. Now, if we take a look at the history, you'll see that it's okay as far as the single core goes. It's about the same, and multi-core is similar as well, depending on which time we're talking about. It actually is a little bit lower, but I did run this right after I installed it, so it could go up if I ran it again. Now let's take a look at these devices so you can compare what I have here with what you have. On the left, I have the iPad Air 2, followed by the iPhone 6S Plus in the middle and the iPhone 11 on the right. And so these scores should give you a general idea from the oldest devices to one of the newest devices and give you a general idea of how it should perform if you're running the same test. Now at this point, don't expect any other major updates with iOS 13, basically at this point forward until iOS 14 comes out to the public later this fall, late September or October at this point. I wouldn't expect anything other than security updates and maybe a few bug fixes. It's pretty much feature complete at this point, so iOS 13 is finally fairly stable, and of course I'll have a follow-up to see how it's doing for you based on the poll and everything else. So hopefully it holds up really well. Only time will tell. It will take a few days to know how battery is for everyone else as well. So that's it for iOS 13.6.1, and this was just a small bug fix, and at this point Apple's really working on iOS 14 to hopefully make it a much better, more stable update for all of us. So I would expect iOS 14 beta 5 probably next week, Tuesday or Wednesday at this point, and of course I'll keep you updated on Twitter and YouTube as well as soon as that comes out. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.